Something is missing in Heather Brake's life.
Yep, sure is.
It wasn't cheap.
No, it wasn't.
And she doesn't know where it is.
No, haven't got it.
It should be here, but all she has to show for her $12,000 is a hole in her backyard.
One on this side of that container, one on the other side of the other one.
And a hole in her bank account.
Yeah, no, it was just gutted, yeah, losing that much money.
And there's plenty of holes in backyards all around New Zealand.
You give our effing money back, you.
The police are on the chase.
There is a mail of interest.
But the people with the missing money are still operating.
William, is it possible that you're just a scammer?
Let's start with Heather Brake in Rotorua. She wanted a container and there were plenty on Facebook.
I messaged them all.
She settled on Condex containers.
And these ones seemed really genuine and they were good price.
$12,000 for two 20-foot brand new containers. Heather paid up in full.
And it was in New Zealand numbers, New Zealand company, everything like that. New Zealand bank accounts.
Everything was going well.
Hello.
Till the phone rang.
They were going to deliver them and then all of a sudden they weren't coming. They needed some money to have them released from Auckland. No, sorry, I'm not giving you 15,000. I've already given you 12. I don't have any more to give you. Sorry, you've already got all my money.
What's worse, Heather's containers never showed up.
Everything started going downhill and tried to get the money back through the bank, but their bank said no, their client refused to refund us.
And Condex containers have blocked her on Facebook and won't take her calls.
They're just rip-offs. I hope no one else puts their money into them.
Kia ora, Wayne here.
For Wayne and Kat of Carbido, it was easy too.
So yeah, we're after a 20-foot container.
Wayne wanted two containers, but Kat was cautious.
She says, nah, we'll get one container first, and once it arrives, then we'll get the second one.
For $5,000, they were going to get the container delivered to Opotiki.
Then we can take you to where the container's going to be placed on site.
On delivery day, they packed the car and headed off. Wayne even got a call from the truck driver with his container.
About 2 hours. Oh, yeah, you must be about at Tauranga.
They were expectant.
Yeah.
And excited.
They're already picturing where the container's going and...
Then the little wait got bigger.
Oh, we were there for hours.
And bigger.
From lunchtime till dark. 6 hours.
Eventually, the inconceivable was the only logical conclusion. Their container was not arriving.
Empty. Empty in the guts. Not for food.
Especially at a time like this.
The paper mill closed up here last year and it got made redundant.
But then the man with their money returned.
Then he rings back the next morning. Sorry, we had truck issues.
Wayne was insistent on a phone number.
No, you tell me the number now. Do not call, do not text. Tell me the number now.
Whenever we cornered him in a phone call, he would eventually just, yes, wait 1 minute, 15 seconds later, hang up.
Yeah, no, the number we talked to you yesterday.
But then he'd ring back the next day.
I'm off the container.
He even got family members posing as potential customers to try to lure them.
But it depends on your location, so where are you located?
Every time, a slightly different scenario.
Different name and different account number every time.
They also tried their bank, but they had...
empty the account and closed it.
There he is, right there. Container ripoff.
Kat did make one more phone call to Condex. It was the day she lost her call. Wayne remembers it fondly.
You give our effing money back, you an arsehole.
Yeah, I had let out what I had held on to, I guess, for all that time.
We did find containers, lots of them. This is the Auckland headquarters of international container giant Royal Wolf. Their boss, Paul Crichton, says demand has surged, prices have doubled, and their uses have multiplied.
The dangerous goods containers, refrigeration containers, offices, lunchrooms, amenity buildings for the construction industry, down to just what we call standard tin cans for dry goods storage.
And it turns out Royal Wolf have also been scammed.
A scam invoice that I have seen is very limited to actually what's on it.
Fake companies were using Royal Wolf's address on their invoices.
Oh, it's frustrating because it's a bad look on the industry.
Are you right, Patrice? So I guess the first question is, do you own a cargo container yourself?
I don't. My father does, but I don't.
Senior Sergeant Greg Dalzell says this is a classic non-delivery scam. The only way to beat it is to do your homework, which includes...
Also looking for things like emails, phone numbers, a location. Does it actually have a physical location? Well, I guess you're safe nowhere. You just have to do your background checks. Social media are there to connect people and does it very well. But you just have to be very aware that there are people out there trying to get your money.
Sergeant Dalzell says they're hunting a man in Christchurch who may have Pat, Wayne's and Heather's money.
There is a male of interest and we're still trying to locate that person.
While the police investigate, the scammers are still operating.
G'day, I'm after a container. Do you do containers? I've been looking at a website and this phone number was there.
This is William from Condex Container.
We thought we'd call the Condex Container hotline.
Yeah, the training for you cost 5,500 dollars.
It's an Auckland landline number that a Wellington-based tech firm sells to overseas companies to make them look local.
We are located in Otara, Auckland.
What's your address?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Currently, we do not accept clients to our address, so we cannot provide that.
Okay. William, I've got a couple of people who I know who brought containers off you, and the containers never showed up. What's going on?
We do not do that type of business.
Where's the money, William?
We do not do that type of business.
You've got Heather in the Rotorua. She paid you $12,000 for two containers. Where's her money, William? William, is it possible that you're just a scammer?
No, sorry. We did not do that.
The Condex Container's Facebook page does have some interesting followers, like Titi, who says she's in West Auckland, but seems to spend a lot of time in Cameroon.
Where are you right now, William?
I'm saying we are based in Otara.
You're in Otara, so what's your address?
Wayne and Kat, who are still $5,000 short, want to know the same thing.
What's your address, bro? What's your address?
Wayne has a piece of advice, too.
Get a job and earn your own money, bro.
Wayne will save again, maybe from his pool winnings.
Make him fight for his win.
And eventually, him and Kat will get a container. But this hurt, he'll remember.
They're scamming people out of money's low life, eh? That's what you are.
They're just low-lifes.